Welcome to the second part of our little feature on Langkawi and why it's so popular with us yachties. And in this episode we're going to see a bit more of what it has to offer, and I think we're going to do a little bit of, guess what?
Not sailing. Sailing?
Yeah, we might get some. Yeah, we might get some sailing.
Oh, at last.
Right, hold it. Stop right there. I don't know what these two are prattling on about, but there'll be none of this sailing nonsense in this video. This is about a little trip around Langkawi by road. And of course, what a video clip from Follow the Boat wouldn't be complete without some boat maintenance. So ignore these two about the sailing. That comes next time. Let's crack on with a bit of playing around with some spanners and then go for a little tour around the remainder of Langkawi.
Hello.
Morning. How are you?
Okay, good.
One fixed gearbox.
Zionel the mechanic returns and fits our reconditioned gearbox and new damping plate. Whilst he's doing this, we isolate the power and the solar panels to the batteries so that when he leaves, I can tend to my job of checking the batteries.
Batteries. I haven't tested them for a few weeks now, so I'm just going to test that the water is up to the correct level, the acid's up to the correct level. If it isn't, I add a bit of distilled water, and I'll use the hydrometer to check the specific gravity. You always need lots of cloths when you're working with batteries for mopping up spillages, and I always find an old pair of Jamie's thunder pants
trick. Sorry, what did you call them?
Jamie's thunder pants.
Thunder pants?
Yeah, because there's a lot of thunder that comes out of those sometimes.
I should just say, can you hold those up again? That is merely the wide-angle lens on the camera that makes them look large. I am just a size 32 waist.
Yeah. You had to throw these away because they were too small, didn't you?
Yep.
So I'm just going to take the waistband off, which is crap. I should have done this before, but
I'll do it now. So whilst Liz cuts that cloth, I'll tell you a little bit about the batteries for those who are interested. We have 4 6-volt golf cart batteries, and they're made by Exide. Bought them in India, so they're over 3 years old now and they serve us well. Because they're 6-volt, they have to be put in series and then in parallel. So we have 2 batteries in series to make 12 volts. So the 2 sets of 12 volts, each at 110 amps, makes 440 in total. So yachtsmen often talk about pink jobs and blue jobs. This looks like a blue job to me. Why are you doing it?
Yeah, old fashioned sexist. Yachtsmen talk about pink and blue jobs. Basically because you do most of the blue jobs. Just because you've got a bit more experience, I suppose, from DIY and stuff like that. And if there's something I can do, I like to try and do it, and this is something I don't mind doing.
That wasn't the answer I was expecting.
What were you expecting?
I was expecting you to say that you have far more patience with the fiddly jobs than I do. And also this requires some kind of regimentation, because it should be done often. You've even got a little spreadsheet, haven't you, that you fill up and record the gravity and the charge.
I used to when I started, but I didn't really know, but now I know what I'm doing. I do remember. So this battery specific gravity is fine. So I do 1 battery at a time, and the next job in this battery then is to fill up. So right. So that distilled water is right up to the edge of the lip now, which is the mark that you're supposed to follow.
Well, I'll leave you to that, and I'll go and have a chat with Millie and find out what she's doing.
Yeah, likes to help sometimes.
Millie, what are you doing? Millie? Yeah? What job are you doing today?
After a few hours of boat maintenance, we take the rest of the afternoon off and go for a drive. First stop is Langkawi's second marina, Telaga.
This is the north side of Telaga Harbour, and we like it here for two reasons. The first is the fabulous bakery called The Loaf, and then there's a fantastic Italian restaurant called Mare Blu, which does happy hour beers from 3 until 8 o'clock. First, we're going to go and get some croissants.
The row of shops and restaurants to the north of Telaga Marina have a certain continental feel to them, especially as the bakery does fantastic pastries. We wander down to Mare Blu and take a seat looking out across the bay. Just up the road from Telaga is the bafflingly named Pantai Kok.
This is an area that's quite often bypassed by tourists, but it's really, really popular with the locals, especially on Fridays when they come here to picnic and to have lunch served in the local little stalls along here. Get noodles and fish and very simple dishes, and really fresh and quite delicious. We come here quite a lot. The beach is called Pantai Kok, and behind me you'll see a lot of yachts anchored. It's a real favourite with the yachties here for anchoring, nice and sheltered. And there are two man-made islands. The islands were made for a film here, and they provide a little bit of shelter and a great anchorage.
Heading further north still, past the sky cab, are the Seven Wells. This is a trek up the mountain to a freshwater bathing station, but first we have to sit out the rain.
Jamie, could you explain to me exactly why you brought me here?
Okay, well, this is a little taster of Langkawi's microclimate. 1 minute it's sunny, next minute it's raining. When we left the marina earlier, it was bright sunshine, it was really hot. And halfway across the island, we could see a bank of clouds around the north of the island. So I thought I'd give you a little taste of what it's really like to be travelling around Langkawi. Even in the space of an hour, it can change like this. But we're actually here at the Seven Waterfalls, which is next to the cable car. And obviously they've stopped the cable car, that's not running at the moment. I remain optimistic that over there is lighter sky and this will pass. And if it does, then we'll go for a little trek up to the Seven Waterfalls, which if we get up there is well worth checking out.
Yeah, okay, well you go and I'll follow.
Get those walking boots on.
The rain continues, so we buy a couple of umbrellas and make our way up the concrete steps to the Seven Wells. Not the Seven Waterfalls, stupid. By the time we get there, the rain has stopped.
So here we are at the top of the Seven Wells, it's called. And it's a bit of a climb. This isn't just sweat, this is rain. We stomped up how many metres, Liz? Can you remember?
Oh, I don't know. We did...
Blimey, no, I can't remember.
You were supposed to be counting the steps, weren't you?
Yeah, but then I noticed halfway through that they tell you how many steps there are, so I didn't bother.
Behind me, you probably can't see it now, but it's the cable car. And although it's been raining, we do have a fantastic view of the misty mountains behind and eventually out onto the sea. What's surprising though, since we've come up here last time, is that they've started building this bridge. And I guess it's a little lookout bridge, it only goes halfway across the pools. But when that's finished, that will offer an even more fantastic view of the Seven Worlds here and of the mountains behind.
Yeah, I remember last time we were here, we went right to the edge there and there was a sign saying don't go beyond here, but of course we did, and we did take some shots from here, didn't we?
Yeah, and of course the other thing we did last time was put on our swimming costumes and went for a little dip in the pool. Now I did bring my costume with me, should I put it on?
Oh, go on, do it, you'd be the only one in there.
Well, if I do, I don't think we're going to be recording that bit.
Much to the distress of the general public, Jamie slips on his trunks and takes a dip in one of the pools.
Oh, I have to say, that is fantastic.
Is it cold?
Well, it's not really cold, no. It's cool, but no, it's pleasant, it's really pleasant. And I love the atmosphere of the steam coming off the rocks here. Of course, the sun's come out now, so it's starting to warm up again.
Can you reach the bottom in this pond?
Yeah. If I stand up. There we go. It's only so deep.
Yeah.
But I'm kind of hoping that this is fresh rainwater that I'm bathing in.
Yeah, it's gorgeous up here, and just look at the way the climate has completely changed. Well, not the climate, the weather has just changed. From thunderstorms to beautiful blue sunny sky and rock pools and waterfalls. Lovely.
The constant stream of water has smoothed the rock faces and created gullies that allow visitors to slip and slide down into the pools beneath.
And if we'd carried on, he'd have gone through this little channel here. You see, it's going quite fast, and then, oh, it goes over the edge.
Well, it didn't take much persuading. Shorts are off, so you couldn't resist the slide. Yeah, go stick on the left-hand side.
Not wanting to miss out, I stripped to my underwear and joined Jamie in the fun.
Number four, this time forwards. Yay, success!
On the way back from the Seven Wells, in between Pantai Kok and Kuala Periang, is a little fishing village we like to pop into from time to time. We climb the little footbridge to take in the views.
Right, Jamie, so this is my birthday, and...
Happy birthday.
Thank you. Where are we going today?
We are going absolutely nowhere. And we're not even going to go into town to fix some of these problems because it's a bank holiday Monday. This whole weekend we've been plagued with shops being closed, and that delayed us to start with. But it's probably just as well we've run into this problem now whilst we're still in the marina, because if this had happened over in Koh Lipi or wherever we were going to go, we would have been up Shit Creek.
So tell me what the problem is.
Okay, so what happened was we were starting the engine and it would run for a little bit and then it would vibrate and conk out. And basically what it could have been a couple of things. It could have been air in the system or dirty fuel. And I thought dirty fuel at first, but we're very diligent about cleaning our fuel. I've checked the fuel, that looks okay. So we think it's air. And so what we did was we spent ages on the fuel lift pump, pumping the pump away to try and get fuel through. And how long were we doing it for? An hour?
At least, yeah.
Yeah. So basically no fuel was coming through from the fuel lift pump to the last filter. We've got three fuel filters, so it was going through the first two but not getting to the third one. So we've taken the fuel lift pump apart. The gauze in there was pretty knackered and there was a bit of dirt in there, so we replaced that, put it back on. There was air coming out the fuel lift pump, so I've replaced one little gasket on that, and that seemed to solve that problem. Then what we had to do was to take the union nuts off the atomizers, which is something I've never done before. I've never got this delved this far into the engine, but the idea is that by releasing those nuts, once you've got fuel through that filter, the fuel should then come through the injectors. So the idea is you turn the engine and it should push out any trapped air. Whilst I was doing that, I tightened up one of the nuts and one of the pipes that goes to the atomizers has split and it was pissing fuel. Now, whether that was me actually creating that problem by tightening it up or whether it was already there and it's just got worse, we don't know. So in a nutshell, we have to replace all of the pipes between the atomizers.
Okay, so what's happened then?
Okay, well, the good news is we found 4mm inside diameter pipe for the return fuel system on top of the atomizers, so something.
Good.
The two main fuel hoses that we're trying to replace that have got the metal sheath around it, I've taken it to another shop. He reckons he can do it.
Hooray!
He'll probably have to use the same fittings though, because they don't have the fittings. But the bad news is it's not going to be ready until tomorrow afternoon.
Which means the very earliest we can leave is Thursday.
Yep. That's if we get the engine going.
Yeah.
Which we hope we can, so.
So
it's sort of one step forwards, two step back, and then another step forwards, and then a pause, and then, yeah. Annoying.
Okay, well, watch this space. Our final stop is Legenda Park, situated between Kwa's main mosque and the jetty. This manicured treasure is underrated, perhaps because most people don't like to be out in the midday sun, and who can blame them, yet there are many covered walkways to perambulate. The park has some interesting and sometimes amusing water features, and a large part of the park is put aside for swings and slides, so it's a great place to bring the kids.
For adults, there's plenty of flora to discover.
Where hast thou been since I saw thee? Unhelp me more about that.
We return to the park in the evening and catch all kinds of creatures lit up by coloured lights in the trees. Enough swanning around Langkawi. It's about time we left. But have we had any luck with that damn engine?
Right, Jamie, how are we getting on with this air leak then? What's the latest?
We've got two new fuel hoses here which were pretty damaged and battered, and that was what caused the problem in the first place. By taking these off, that introduced the air into the engine, into the fuel system. And if you remember yesterday or the day before, I'd actually broken one of these, so I've replaced those, put the fuel pipe in, primed the fuel, so we've got no air in this side of the engine. But what we have to do now is to crack open one of these nuts here, which is on the high pressure side. So the idea being that you start the engine and any excess air will get pushed out through the high pressure fuel system and then tighten that. So according to the instruction manual, I'm supposed to crack open all four, and I have to say two of them are impossible to get to. The first one is so tight I can't undo it, but the second one I've managed to crack open, so I've loosened it off. So what we need to do now is to start the engine and see what happens.
Well, here goes nothing. Shall we give it a try?
Yep.
Success! With the engine now working, hoses replaced, and refurbished gearbox, Esper and her crew can escape the clutches of the marina and set sail once more.
Well, I really hope you enjoyed that, and I hope we've whetted your appetite about Langkawi, because we really like it.
Yeah, we do. It's a great place, and it's a place that whilst we're in the area, we'll keep coming back to and popping in and saying hi and travelling around and doing all the things we've just done in these last two features.
Except the boat maintenance, let's hope.
Yeah, right. Okay, well, I think that pretty much wraps things up. In the next episode, we have a very special feature on a group of local people who are doing something for the environment, so it makes great viewing.
Same, the flip-flop.
Yeah.
Yes. Now in Patani, wait for recycle, for make the floor. Mm-hmm. And if finish, okay, I want one for here. Mm-hmm. PO have a gym.
Yep.
Just make the floor.
So make the floor.
Yes. For show, you know, yeah. For show everyone, yeah. What the rubbish can recycle.
And in the meantime, if you'd like to continue to support us, then don't forget to check out our Patreon page.
Yep, and like us on Facebook, and we tweet, and we Instagram, which is a new thing for us.
Yeah, it is new, actually. Yeah. We've kind of neglected Instagram, but we realised that we're taking so many photographs, doing what we're doing, then I guess we should be sharing them, shouldn't we?
Yeah, we should. So come along and just have a look and see what we're doing.
All right.
Yep.
And?
Follow
the
boat.
Follow the boat!
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 Follow the boat with the pizza in the hand!
Calm down and just follow the boat!